Hello my friend, this is Rakesh and welcome to the part 5 of the ASP.NET Core 2.0 Razor Pages series. In this video, I will cover the OnPost method. In the previous video, we have discussed on the OnGot method, OnGet method, and we have displayed a list over there in the Razor Pages. And in the current video, we will cover the OnPost method and we will post the data and we'll save the data in the database, and then we'll see in the list page that do our data have been saved. So what are the different points I will cover in the current video? Let's go and check in the PPT. I have created the PPT for the same, and we're working on the OnPost. We will check the OnPost method. We will use the existing database connection, the same database connection which I have used in the previous example in which I used the OnGet method, and we will use the existing context services which I have added in the previous context services to the container in the service as we have added in the previous example. So we will use the same, and apart from this we will use the same model and the context class, student model and core student core DB context class, which I have used in the previous example. And apart from this, I have to use the dependency injection again, because I will use and I will create the new page for adding the records into the database. And after this, I will post that data from the Razor page UI to the code behind pages, and we will save it into the database. And after saving, we will redirect the user to the list page so that we can view the changes that the changes have been saved and do that it is being pulled by the OnGet method or not. So without wasting time, let's move to the Visual Studio and we'll cover all these points one by one. So right now, this is the same example which we have used in the previous video. So right now, I'll click on the right click on the page and will add and Razor pages. So I will create a Razor page and I will name it add student. So I will name it add student, and as I have already mentioned, the layout need not to mention the layout name, because if you have mentioned the layout in the view start this, then that will become the default layout. So if I'm explicitly adding it, then it never harm. You can add or it's all depend upon you. So I will add it, add student. So it will take a few seconds to add, and you will get add student model name of this page, and a model will be appended over there, and it will be inherited from this model page model class, and it also have the backend class, and this is the HTML page which have the page directive, and then this model, and then this server side code for this mentioning layout and title. And here is the space for where we can write our HTML form. We can design our HTML form. So we will move now. Friends, we will create the onPost method, which is not by defaultly available over there. So we can create the onPost method like this. And this is the asynchronous method. As you can see, the async keyword over there. And when we create the async method, we need to wrap iActionResult abstract class into the task. And this is giving the warning, because whenever we are using the async, we have to use the await keyword. Async and await keywords are some both need to be used in the same method. So we have to use the await method. Once we will use the await method, this warning will go. So this is the asynchronous method. We can also create the non-asynchronous method like this simple method. In that case, we have to remove this asynchronous task and this one, then this will be our normal method. So I will cover the create the synchronous method in the example. So I will delete this, and now I will create the constructor over there in this class, as we have already created over this created over there in this page. So I will go and I will copy paste the code from here. I have added a context. And now after this, I will add the constructor to inject the dependencies, and I'm using the constructor in dependency injection. So that's all we have to do to inject the dependency. Now I will use this context over here. So what I have to write this context dot student dot add. Here I will add the model which will come from the backend class, the HTML part, and then I will use context dot save changes asynchronously, because I'm using the asynchronous keyword over there. So I have to use the await keyword. Here I have to pass the object which will come from the backend. So here we have to pass the object which will be come from the backend. So for this we have to create a property, and I will create a property, student property. So I have not created the list over there as in the previous example, because there is a single entity will come from the backend, and we have to decorate this property with the bind property. If you will not decorate this property with the bind property, your model will not get binded, and you will not get the model value what have been posted from the backend. So this is mandatory in case of the post. When you are posting the data, your model should be mandatory. It is mandatory to be decorated with the bind property. So I have used this mod, this student model, and I will add it over here. So, and after this, I will return redirect to page. So this is the new method which is redirect to result, permanent result. All these methods were already available in the MVC, but redirect to page is newly added in the MVC in the ASP.NET Core 2.0. Right now we are dealing with the razor pages, so we are dealing with the all pages. So that's why redirect to pages, this new action results have been added and into the abstract class, this action result, right? So after saving this, synchronously saving this, I want the user to be redirected to the student list, where we can check that record have been saved or not. And before this, we can check, add a check for the model, that if not model state dot is valid, if your model is not valid, then what we have to do, you have to return the user to the pages. So pages will by default redirect the user to the create pages. So I will again write over here in this method. So you're okay, it's void. So I can write the action result over there, so that action result. And this is this is the normal method, and this is the asynchronous method. You can see the difference. I have not wrapped the task over here. If you want to make it asynchronous, then you can write the asynchronous and wrap this action result with the task. And you have to use the await over there when in your processing, when the final work is done, getting done, right? So this is all code we have to do for saving purpose. Now I will do the build of this project. And now we have done with the code, let's add the link of this page in the layout. So as we have done in our previous page, so I will add this over here and contact us. I will make a copy of this and then contact us and add student. So these are the two links I have added over there, add student and list of the students. So let's run this. Friends, I have added the link over there. So before running the project, let's add the HTML part to this. So I have already added the written the HTML. So I will copy paste that HTML, and in this HTML we have added a div row, and after that call MD4. So there are the 12 columns at all. So we have defined the medium column 4. So your text boxes, this div will be in the 33% of your whole screen. If you'll define 8, then 66% of the length will be. If you'll define MD12, then the text boxes length will be to the whole screen. Is this direction to this direction, x to y. Right. So form method is post, and these are the classes are available in Bootstrap. So you can check the Bootstraps classes and your Bootstrap help on the internet, you will come to know. So this is the tag helper classes which we have used, and this is the label, and it have binded with the student or student name, and this is the input box. So again, same way we have binded the admission date. This is the label as we were using in the ASP.NET earlier, and this is the input form label and input form label input form, and then submit input button. Type is submit, and this will form submit the form, and this is the post method. So I have used the student method over there. So this whole data will be posted, will get posted to the this whenever we click on that post button, that will come over here, right? So I will put the debugger over here, and now let's build successfully. Let's run. So friends, now the application has run, and we are on this add student page, and you can see that these fields are available for me. So I will create pass the name. Suppose I pass Smith, and here I have opened this in the Chrome. So this calendar is coming because of only this Chrome. So I will push any date. I will add a date, then time, and gender male, and class earth. So I will click on the create, and now we will check model is validated is true. So if model will be not validated, then it will return back to their same pages, and we'll see in this model whatever values 8th standard male ID will not be saved on there, that will be automatically saved. And this is a date and name of the student is this, and added into the context, and then it will be saved a synchronous method, and then user will be redirected to the list page. So now it is calling the onGet method of the list page C, and I will do the F5 C. This is latest record which we have saved, the 8th standard and the Smith that has got saved over there. So in this way you can create the your add method, you can create the list method, whatever method you want. So you can make the use of the onGet and onPost method as I have explained to you. So what we learned in the current video, we work with the onPost method. We use the existing database connection and existing context services to the container, and same model and context classes was used. We resolve the dependency as we have resolved in the previous method, and then we post the data from the UI, and it gets saved into the database. And the main point in the case of the post is need to be taken care is that whenever we create this model which need to be communicated with this, we need to decorate it with the property, sorry, attribute bind property. Otherwise this method, this once you will post it from your HTML part, you will not get anything over here. It will always come null. So if it is coming null, so you could understand that you have not decorated with the property bind property. So in the case of the get, it is visible without this, but in case of the post you have to use it, right? And this is the dependency injection, and you can save the data as per you, and you can use the synchronous method and non-asynchronous method as per your demand. Friends, in this way we learn about the post and onGet method, and in the next coming video we'll cover the next it's a scaffolding feature, that how you can use it's a scaffolding feature, and how you can create the different pages using that, and you can create the pages, and you can learn more on this. And please motivate me by liking and subscribing my channel, and if you have any comment, then please post on the video, and I will try my level best to reply on that, and we'll see you in the next video. Till then, take care and bye.